Hello everyone, welcome to EdiTalk. So in today's session, we are going to discuss a very important finance news article regarding the SEBI, that is the Securities and Exchange Board of India, that has come out with the new guidelines for the KYC registration agencies. So we will see that what are these new guidelines, why the SEBI has come out with it, what are the benefits, what is the timeline and everything. Okay. So now before starting with the session, please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you are new to the channel and join our Telegram channel for the PDF of this session. And you can get the link of the Telegram channel in the description box below. So now starting with the news article, like the SEBI has come out with the new guidelines for the KYC registration. So first of all, what are the KYC registration agencies? So the CRAs are the KYC registration agencies. This is the short form KRAs. They are functioning in the securities market. That's why they are coming under the SEBI. Okay. So CRAs are working under the securities market. They are working under the SEBI since 2011, and they are the repository records of KYC of clients in securities market, including the mutual funds market. So they are the repository. They have the storage of all the KYC records of the clients of the mutual fund clients also. Okay, so KRAs, I hope now you understand that they have the records. They are the repository. Okay, so now capital market regulator SEBI has issued fresh guidelines for the KRAs, whereby such agencies will have to independently validate the KYC records of all clients starting from July 1st of 2022. So they will be validating, they will be cross-checking, they will be checking that the KYC details are coming right or not. Okay, so now SEBI, see, there was a regulations that was released by the SEBI on January 28th, and recently a new circular has come that told additional information about the CRAs and about the new guidelines for the KYC registration agencies. Okay, so in the when the regulation came on January, then the definitions regarding the KRA came, and definition regarding the RI, that is the registered intermediaries, came. And these definitions are very important to understand that what are KRA. You have understood a brief about the KRA, that they are the repository of the KYC records. They store the KYC records as well as they will be validating the KYC records now. So KRA shall be responsible for storing, safeguarding, retrieving the KYC documents and submit to the board or any other authority whenever it is needed. So they will be saving it, and whenever it is needed, they will be providing it in front of the SEBI, like some investor has done some default or something. So the KRA will provide the documents of that investor for the rechecking and everything to the SEBI and the other authority. So KRA shall carry out an independent validation of the KYC records uploaded onto its system. So on its system, the KYC that has been uploaded, and we will understand that who uploads the KYC details. So the KRA will be validating it, will be rechecking it. Okay. So the intermediary, that is the registered intermediaries, shall perform the initial KYC. So a registered intermediaries will start the KYC process. So they will initiate the KYC process. They will have the all the data, all the documents from the investors, from the clients, and that documents will be stored, will be sent to the KRA. Okay, so the intermediaries shall perform the initial KYC due diligence of the client, upload the KYC information with proper authentication, with proper documents. They have to upload the KYC details on the system of the KRA, furnish the scanned images of the KYC documents to the KRA. They have to submit the documents to the KRA through digital system, or if the physical copy has come, so they have to submit it to the KRA and retain the physical KYC documents with themselves also. So now the move comes after SEBI in January notified new norms to make KRAs responsible for carrying out independent validation of the KYC records uploaded onto their system by registered intermediaries. So the regulations has come in January only, and after that there is some new information that came in the circular regarding the process. We will see the process now. Okay, so the registered intermediaries are the stock brokers, they are the depository, they are the depository participants, as well as the registrar and transfer agents that work for the mutual funds that have mutual fund companies that have all the information regarding the transactions that is happening by the, that is done by the investors. They have all the RTAs have all the information that they store for the mutual funds, okay, that they collect for the mutual funds also. And RTAs for the mutual funds, they collect the KYC details also, okay. So that's why these are the intermediaries that collect the data and they have to upload it in the system of the KRA, okay. So that was all. Now the rules we will see that has come in the new regulations and that has come in the new circular. So under the notified rules, the KRAs will have to maintain an audit trail of the upload, that what has been uploaded, if the modification has come, like the KYC has been done before but there is a modified Aadhaar card that has come. So the modification, the downloads that has been done, that why the intermediary has also downloaded, like some other intermediary has taken the KYC details, so why it has happened. So with respect to the KYC records of the clients, of the investors, so SEBI said KRAs will independently validate records of those clients that are existing as well as new. So existing clients validation will also happen again, as well as the new clients that will come after the July 1st. Okay. So whose KYC has been completed using Aadhaar as an officially valid document. So they will again see the records of the existing as well as new clients. So the records of those clients who have completed KYC using non-Aadhaar, the officially valid document, if they have posted anything else, anything, any other document other than the Aadhaar card, then they will have to validate upon receiving the Aadhaar number. So that is, it will not happen. The validation will not complete until the client has given the Aadhaar number or something related to Aadhaar card, like the photo of Aadhaar card, or they have just sent the Aadhaar number. So KRAs will continue to act as repository of KYC data in the securities market. It's not like they will not store it now. They will continue storing the data and everything, but they will start the validation also. So and will be responsible for storing, safeguarding and retrieving the KYC documents. So still they will have all of these work to do, but a new work has been added, that is validation now. So verification and benefit. So why it has been given to the KRA, we will see that. During the process of validation, the KRAs will validate details related to the Aadhaar through the UIDAI, that is the Unique Identification Authority of India. So they will recheck the Aadhaar number with the UIDAI authentication. They will recheck the PAN using the income tax database. So it's why they are validating. How they are validating? So they are validating by rechecking those numbers with the actual database that they have available. So tax database they will use, and mobile number and email ID will be verified using one-time password. Okay, if the mobile number is not the same as given in the Aadhaar card, then one-time password will be sent. Okay, so this is the validation that how it will be carried out. Then the systems of RIs and the KRAs. So the registered intermediary system and the KRA systems will be integrated so that there will be a faster, smoother movement of the documents from one place to another. KRAs will promptly inform the respective RIs if there is some deficiency that is happening. Like one intermediary is creating too much problem, like all the data they are collecting are wrong. So they will tell that intermediary that there is some deficiency, inadequacy in the client's KYC documents if any is observed by the KRA, and steps will be taken then. So on successful completion of KYC validation, SEBI said that a unique client identifier called KRA identifier will be assigned by the KRA to the client. And see, this is why the SEBI has taken the step. You will understand now that what is the benefit of giving the validation process to the KRA. So now what will happen, such a KRA identifier that is given to the client that has completed the validated the KYC process. So this KRA identifier may be used by the client for opening of account with any other intermediary without repeating the KYC process. So right now what was happening, that when RIs, the registered intermediaries, were taking the whole process, like different at all the times, if the investor want to do something, like they want to trade in stock, they want to invest in the mutual fund, they have to do the KYC again and again, again and again. So now it has been said that they would not have to repeat the KYC process because the KRA will provide them with a KRA identifier. They have already done, they have already completed the process of KYC verification with the KRA. So KRA will give them the identifier, and through that they can relate or they can connect with the any of the intermediary that is working under the SEBI. And so this has become very easy for the person also, for the client, for the investors also, as well as for the intermediaries, because they will not have to go through the whole process of the KYC verification again and again. Like different intermediaries will doing the KYC process and it was taking time. Okay, so now they will not have to do it if it has been done by the KRA once. So next is timeline, how much time it will take. So the KYC records of new clients who have used Aadhaar as an officially valid document will be validated within 2 days of receipt of the KYC records by the KRAs. So the intermediary has taken your documents and then the documents will go to the KRA, and when after the KRA receives the document, within 2 days you will be verified. Okay. So the records of all existing clients will be validated within a period of 180 days from July 1. So it's not like only new clients will get the validation, the existing clients will get the validation within 180 days also. So it is a very fast process that is going to happen. So KRA will have to intimate about the KRA identifier to the client within 2 working days of receipt of KYC record. So as I have said that within 2 days, the verification will be completed and the KRA identifier will be provided to the client or the investor. This has to be done by post or email. By the post or email, you have to send the identifier to the client. And the KRA concerned will have to maintain the proof of dispatch that actually they have given the identifier to the person, to the investor or the client, they have given or not. Okay, so they have to keep a proof with themselves also. So this was the whole news article regarding the KRA, regarding the new guidelines by the SEBI, regarding the new regulations and the circular by the SEBI. So now, as per the SEBI guidelines, which of the following is responsible for storing, safeguarding and retrieving the KYC documents? I hope you can easily tell the answer now, that which is the one organization that do this. Okay. So now these were the people that gave the right answer of the previous session question, that is Nilesh and Nivedita, Hansa, Shakti, BS, Yash, Arvind, Dipali, Ravikant, Sumit and Marshan. The fifth was the right answer, that is none of the above. All the above options were right. Okay. So thank you very much. If you have any query, you can mail us here or you can contact us through this number. Thank you very much.